with a distinction for services rendered in the cause of Carnatic music. I have now great pleasure in requesting Justice Mr. V. R. Krishnaya, who has kindly acceded our request to be present this evening with us, to address this gathering and to present this shawl on behalf of the Carnatic Sangeetha Sabha. Thank you.
Friend, my only alibi for this prosaic intrusion, when I am also waiting to hear divine music, is the command of Colonel Iyer to speak a few words on an occasion which is at once felicitous and appropriate, because one of the greatest exponents of Carnatic music has been recently honored by the President, conferring on him the award of Padma Shri. Could anything be more appropriate than this when he sings first in the capital city after that noble occasion? Now, M.D. Ramanathan, people are crazy, many people are crazy, and I plead guilty to being crazy about hearing M.D. Ramanathan. Now, that's one of the reasons why I readily consented to speak a few words on this occasion. Now, he is a peculiar phenomenon. He is some kind of an extraordinary institution. And all of you know, he is a school of music by himself in Kalakshetra. This amalgam of a man, he is at once an artist and a scientist, a purist and an experimentalist, and a singer and a composer of songs. Now, this blend is difficult to find ordinarily in any field of art. You might be a great painter, but you might be innocent of the science or the art or the theory of painting. On the other hand, here we have this multi-dimensional, multifaceted personality coming from the far south, but his reputation traveling all over India and abroad. Now, it is only a little too late that he was conferred this award of Padma Shri. And I am afraid a minor recognition of a major personality. Because I think he should really... Now, M.D. Ramanathan, unlike some other artists, sings for his own satisfaction. In fact, authentic aesthetic value of a true artist consists not in winning applause, but in answering the craving of the soul. Now, here is a man whose notes, shall I say, come from the depths of truth. If it is a false thing, however much applause may come, however much appreciation may be showered, he is not bothered about it. Now, he sings for himself. He drowns in himself. He stretches his arms tirelessly towards perfection. And in this communion between his finite personality and the infinite called Nada Brahma, if he pleases you, well and good, but he pleases himself. Now, it is this hallmark of M.D.R. which I suppose wins for him the real applause of sincere connoisseurs, virtuosos and so on. Now, on behalf of the music lovers, especially Karnataka Sangeet of Delhi, let me take this opportunity to add our felicitations to the many which must have come to him during the last few days from all over this country and perhaps from outside. It is only fitting on this occasion to mention that we have a companion Padma Shri, T.N. Krishnan. I have a peculiarly parochial pride in speaking about these two persons because they come from the place where I was born, that is Palghat. Some of you somehow think that these geographical frontiers of Tamil Nadu and Kerala divide the empire of art. Not at all. In fact, Kerala has conquered Tamil Nadu that way. Now, T.N. Krishnan is one of the foremost artists on the violin. And then there is yet another about whom I have another sense of pride because he belongs to my profession. He is an advocate, but somehow has chosen to please people not by advocacy, but playing on the mridangam. And that is Sivaraman. Many of you do not know that he first tried to fit into the legal profession, but thought that this crude, making the worse appear the better reason is not what he wants, but he must really produce something sincere, something soul-stirring, that is true music and the sense of rhythm on the mridangam. Now we have also on the Ginjara, Krishnamurti Ginjara, and I am sure that this team, this extremely happy band of musicians will give us some 3 or 4 hours of celestial music to which I look forward along with you. Let me felicitate, heartily congratulate MDR over again. The traditional way we from the South express our appreciation of great artists is by, shall I say, enveloping him with affectionate shawl. I propose to do that right at this moment. Few words of prose before poetry begins may be fitting from MDR.
Supreme Justice V.R. Krishnayyar, the executive of the Karnataka Sangeetha Sabha, convened by Shankara Narayanan, Avargal, ladies and gentlemen, this is an occasion of the very few when a musician has got a chance to speak in a different language. Usually I speak only in limited circles in my own way, purely on music and other subjects, because I am very far away from politics. I do not know law, I do not know anything as an asset. I know only a little bit of music. After all, I am a humble, very different view. Anyway, providentially, born in a very orthodox and musical family, I was given liberal education. I am told recently that V.R. Krishnayyar is related to V.V. Subramaniar, I was in Paracat and he is a very close family friend of mine. I am really happy over it. So as he has put it, Kerala is as yours. I am proud to say that today two Krishnans are by my side, one Krishnan on my left and another Krishnan before me. This Krishnan is not really a Krishna, he is an Ishwara. His real name, Sarman, is Sayambhageshwara. He told me during one of my journeys, what a happy coincidence. Who else can bear this name except Krishna? Sayambhaga is Dhanurtu Ville. He is a Dhanurveda. So, that is apart. That is one Padma Sri. Now, incidentally, real musicians, devotees of Tyagaraja, we have to be, as Purandaradasa says, Isabelku, something there is nothing line, yet to be in the world and yet out of it. That seems to be the motto of we musicians. We can't get out of the world. Even great thinkers, Swami Vedanta says, be an Indian first, and then you have your own petty quarrels or friendship. So in that spirit, this honor, whether it is by judicial calculation, a minor one or a major one, I do not know. It is all of you to decide. This honor has come to me unawares. I was quite ignorant and what shall I say? No consciousness about these things going outside the world. So such things, as Lord Krishna says, idrcha alapa sandushto, when something comes to you out of its own accord, let us accept it. And if there is anything about me, as he has put it, he says that my fame has broadened itself even out of the country. I do not know how. Anyway, if that is so, I think it is only due to the little devotion I have, both to music and Godhead. Itas praatnodi yugalam, nyadi pradhanyam evacha. Achalam shimatnodi, jalam shimatnodi, so and so, etc. and patanama. You see, there the pustav is there. So in the Balashwari Satanama is, Bhishmacharya says, itas praatnodi yugalam, Godhead, devotees of God, whether they will it or not, it is the will of God to spread the fame and reputation. What Tyagaraja says? Asadira Gurajasamunu Prakajibajasina Sasigadira Vajarati. He is just talking to Rama and having some contact as though, how am I to repay the debt? I am afraid that he never appeared in the court of law. There was no contract between Rama and Tyagaraja as such in the legal sense. He imagines that there is a debt unpayable or beyond payment. He says, Nirunavudipa na tarama. But he says, you have spread my fame beyond. What shall I do for you? You are a Desika Shiromani. What can Desikas do for a musician? As he has put it, envelop them in respect and veneration. This is a token of respect and veneration. If you simply proceed without these things for a concert at this occasion, human feelings will be there. What is this? You're all singing Kana Radhava for so many years. People have no mind at all, perhaps. They do not take into account the great honor done to me. That will be the human sentimental feeling. But a natural man, when things are done in a very sensitive fashion, he feels very elated. So, what I am saying is, I am mixing so many feelings, I do not know what cogency I have managed to. Anyway, let me, without further furtherance of my prosodical expressions, or prosaic expressions,
concludes that I am immensely happy, I am thankful, I am grateful for this warm welcome, for this happy gesture, for this affectionate treatment before this conference. Freely speaking, truly speaking, for these last 2 weeks and odd, I have come, I returned to Madras and returned like this, that and so on, to adjust so many things. There is a lot of physical strain. But with all that, my mind says, no, never mind. Carry on. After all, a bit of physical strain doesn't matter much. When things are done, you know, say. So in that spirit, I am going to sing today. I do not know how far I am able to continue with my physical tiresomeness and all that. But by God willing, I think I will be able to continue for some time to your satisfaction. Thank you, Jinnah.
Thank you. manasu nilve cheka pode
Oh. Because
Chandram Bhavayami Ramachandram Bhavayami Lagupula Tilagamudha Ramachandram Bhavayami
Ramachandram Bhavayami Good morning. Thank you. Yeah. Yeah.
nani da bamagari bamagari satakani
Badani, 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 badani Thank you. Whoa. Yeah. Shabbat. Kimbara de, Sada Kimbara. சிங்காரம் சிதினந்தினி மிகரட ശൃംഗാരം ശ്രീതിലി വിഹരണ
Singaram, Bali Bhajan, Bali Bhajan, Agudarazam, Siddham, Girisam, Paramakarunyam, Bali Bhajan, Agudarazam, Siddham, Girisam, Asyam Shurpanakha Mukhe Asyam Shurpanakha Mukhe Bhayam Akhe Bhayam Akhe Vibhatsavanya Mukhe Thank you.
കാരുണ്യം ഹാസ്യം ശൂർപ്പനകാമുഖേ ഭയവശേ രൗദ്രം രാവണ മുനിജന ശാസ്തരിണ
ജാനകി മനോ ജഗമെല്ലാം ജഗമെല്ലാം അഖില ജഗമെല്ലാം സകല ജഗമെല്ലാം സകല ജഗമെല്ലാം ജഗമെല്ലാം
Bye.
chatre kamare karadite varatalakmana chatre kamare
I'm a little bit of a Really, that is good.